What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over how to fix a timed out error on your Apex Minecraft server. Before we hop into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. Whether it's modded or vanilla, you are probably going to run into some trouble when enjoying your Minecraft server. One of the most common errors when timing out, which can repeatedly occur, is the timed out error. The timed out error is mainly caused by a bad connection to the server, but it can also be a configuration issue. This can become troublesome for a lot of players attempting to join your server. But don't worry, it's a super easy thing to fix, and we're going to show you how to do it through every step of the way. I know. Have you tried copying and pasting in the server IP? This solution is pretty simple. Go ahead and log into your Apex server panel and click on your server. Then once you're on your server panel page, scroll down until you find the IP address, port, and subdomain section. Then just copy both and then hopping into Minecraft and clicking on multiplayer from the main menu. In multiplayer, click on direct connection and then paste in the address in the server address field. And after, you should be able to connect. The other fix we would recommend is just restarting your server and asking the player to join again. Go ahead and hop in your Apex server panel and make sure you're on the right server, and then go ahead and click on restart. It's going to cycle through going offline and then going online, but if you want to check and make sure when you can hop in, you would just click on console at the top left of your panel page, and then in there, make sure you look for the startup done message in console. When you receive this, you should be able to join your Minecraft game and it should fix the situation. But if it doesn't fix the situation, don't worry, and don't forget that you can just make a ticket in billing or on your panel page. If you're running a Forge modded server, make sure that you have random patches from the Cursed Forge webpage installed onto your mod pack and onto your server. And just make sure that the version matches your server version. So if you've got a 1.12.2 server, make sure that you're downloading random patches for a 1.12.2 version of Minecraft. We already have a guide on how to install mods, so we're not going to show you how to install random patches. Instead, in the description of this video, you're going to find links to our guides on how to install mods. Once you know how to install mods on the server and you've gotten random patches installed, all you need to do is restart your server once and just wait for it to load. But you do also have to upload the mod to your local launcher's mod folder. For Minecraft, it's super easy, and all you need to do is hop into Minecraft and click on installations, then look up the little folder icon of the installation that you'd like to fix. Then it'll open up and your mods folder will be front and center. And now all you need to do is click and drag your random patches Forge download and just drag it over to your mods folder. After everything is installed correctly, the server should be online and you should join it to confirm that everything works as intended. Fixing the issue for Fabric servers is also pretty easy. They even have random patches for Fabric. You download it from the same place and make sure to download the correct version for your version of Fabric server. So if you're running a 1.16.5 version of Fabric, make sure that you download a 1.16.5 version of random patches for Fabric. Once you get that installed onto your server, and of course, we have guides on how to do so, make sure to check for that in the description below this video. And once you know how to install mods on your server, just make sure to install the mod onto your Fabric server and then restart the server once it's fully uploaded. Once your server is done loading, you've installed the mod locally, try joining and see if that fixes the situation. But if you're still experiencing issues, make sure to contact support either by opening a live chat or creating a ticket on your billing page. Being timed out from your server is not only annoying, but it's pretty stressful to fix, especially when it's a modded server. The causes for the problem can range, so you may not even know what's really going on. Hopefully, the guide we created will fix the error, However, Apex Hosting has an amazing support team that's 24/7 around the world to determine the connectivity issue if the issue persists. Well, folks, we hope that this video fixed your issue, and we hope you enjoyed this tutorial. As always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.